Alexa, play the Michigan State University fight song.
Play the Michigan State University fight song. For over 90 million songs on the radio, search for Amazon Music on YouTube. Michigan State University fight song. A Michigan State University on Amazon Music.
Alexa, louder. Alexa, louder. Fight, rock team, fight. Victory for MSU. Fight. Hi, Nancy Jones and Nancy Van Buren and Sue Hattu. Yes, I have the Michigan State fight song on. Dun, 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 dun. I am in the green and white mood. Our first game is tomorrow night. I don't know why I'm getting emotional. I guess I've missed football or something. But I am so happy that you are here with me tonight. I'm just getting my comments up here.
Want more entertaining options?
No, Alexa, turn off. Okay, whoo! So how is everyone today? I thought it was Christmas music. Oh, that's coming. Woo-hoo! It's just less than 2 weeks that's coming, Nancy. Oh, it's going to be so fun. Oh, my gosh. How has your week been? Mine's been good. We've had gorgeous weather. It's like Indian summer. Is that what it is in September when it's in the 80s? So, yeah. So what's going on with me? Worked at the studio the last couple days and had some fun there. Always have fun there. I've been making cards. So the mess in my back here, I apologize for that. I'm getting ready for swaps and Cards for Christ class. And I've just been really busy. Like I said, Michigan State plays tomorrow night. I think we play Western, the Broncos. I know we do. So that will be fun. It's a night game. And Courtney is heading out in the morning to go see Megan in Kentucky. So she's going to be gone for the weekend. So it's just Randy and me. And Randy started mowing the lawn when we got home from camping. So he started mowing Monday. And our lawnmower decided to stop moving forward. Shortly after he started. So our grass is still continuing to grow. The lawnmower's in the shop getting fixed, hopefully. And hopefully we'll get it back tomorrow so we can work in the yard all weekend because it's like a hay field. So, okay. So what else is happening, everyone? Nancy, were you at Bacon today? Okay, so it looks like I have three of you on. So I've been playing around. I've been making cards for a swap, and that's my fun fold, and I'm going to show you that tonight. And then I just have to show you a Christmas card, too, because it's just eating at me. And I got an order last night, and I didn't get home till from my... what would you call it? Like a craft show / farmer's market last night. So I was opening it at midnight and I was going crazy because I couldn't use it. So I quickly used it tonight, like 10 minutes ago, and one of the dies. And I'm so excited. And I'm going to show you what I made with it. And we're going to make that card too. So we're gonna be here for a while tonight. I hope you don't mind. If you have to go away, that's fine. You can watch the replay later. Other than that, yeah. Thank you, Sue. Tag people in this if you want them to watch it with you. Share it. Like it. Oh, yeah. Bonnie and Jenny. Yeah, where are they? They need to get on. They will love tonight. I promise you. So if you have to, call them or text them and get them on. Hey, Jenny. Jenny's not. We were just talking about you. So, Nancy, yes, this is the last week in the old building. They are knocking it down to make a parking lot for our new building. So are you going to meet, still continue to meet? Like, do you have a temporary facility you can use or not? Jenny, I'm so glad you're here. I have some happy mail that I got over the last couple weeks. I think I showed you this one last week. This is from my friend Cindy, and she did beautiful watercolor. Here's another one she sent me, and more watercolor. She loves watercolor, can you tell? She should. She's very good at it. And then there's this one. Isn't that pretty? And that's got some dots on it, too. Some three-dimensional dots there. Yeah, and then there's this lattice. Yeah. And yes, I do have green nail polish on. Can you see my shirt? MSU Spartans! Woohoo! Yeah, I am all about that green. And they've gotten a lot of my money, let's just put it that way, and a lot of my girls' money. So yeah, I support them in many different ways. So I'm going to set these aside. Again, my area is just array because I've got multiple things going on, multiple classes, swaps, and just trying to get ready for everything. We're meeting in a local church to distribute food only until we move into the new building next month. Wow, the new building's going to be done in a month? Wow, that's pretty impressive. Very impressive. All right. So I am going to point you to my work surface, and we will get started. I'm going to show you the fun fold first. Say that three times. Fun fold first, fun fold first. Oh, boy. Don't. It's... No, don't. All right, I'm going to point you to my work surface. If you're motion sickness or anything, look away for a few minutes or a few seconds. I'm going to raise you up, and I'm going to point you to my work surface. So we're going to get a lot of motion here. Okay, because I want you to be able to... Okay, how's that? Are we lined up okay? Looks like we might be okay. My hand's in there. I'm waiting for it to show up on my... Yep, there we go. There we go. All right. So, the fun fold we're doing, and I have this... I'm making it for a swap in Indiana. I think... Now, I'm going to be doing two swaps in Indiana, in Indianapolis, on November 12th. And it is a Stampin' Up! Event. It's called On Stage. And we get, the demonstrators get their hands on the new catalog that launches in January, the mini catalog, the new celebration. It seems like we just finished it. We just finished it last night at midnight. And we already, at November 12th, will have our hands on the new brochure for January and February's celebration. So that will be fun. Get to see all new product in that. So that's one of the benefits about being a demonstrator. You get first dibs on everything. All right. So the swap that I'm doing this one for is, it's for my team, not my team, Rhonda's team. So I'm part of her team. So, everyone that's going from her team, we're going to have a designated time to swap. And the theme is from the annual catalog, and find maybe some hidden treasure stamp, one that's overlooked or one that's not used a lot. So, one of the themes also is baby. So I think that's what I'm going to go with. But these are the cards that I've got started so far. Let's see, there's 20 of them there. And this, where is, well, I thought I had a label. I do have a label. So the label is going to go, I'm going to decorate it, of course, and then it's going to go on top there. And then I'm going to have something that sticks out in the sentiment. So anyway, this belly band will slide off like that, and then it opens like that. Isn't that cool? I'm going to show you how to make that tonight. And I hope you like it. So we have to cut off the top and the bottom of each side so we get those angles. So I have this pile of all these triangles, and I thought, there must be something we can do with that, right? I know Nancy Van Puren is all about this. So I thought, well, we could do this and stagger this and trim that off and make some kind of card. I don't know. We'll figure something out, won't we? So I'm putting that aside. Typically, I would just throw that away, but I'm kind of challenged to, I wanna see if I can come up with something. If I can't, I'll pitch it all, but I wanna try first. Okay, I'm gonna leave this off so we can use it as a sample. I'm gonna set this aside. Actually, I'm gonna set it behind me so it's totally out of my way. All right, so the first thing you need, also, this card was featured in one of my friends' Facebook pages. Her name is Denise Will, and I know she would not mind me copying it and sharing it with all of you. I'm just trying to get some more room here so everything's in the picture. So it does take more than a half sheet of paper, so you can only get one card out of a piece of cardstock. You'll have some left over, but not enough to make a full-size card. So you want the dimensions cut at, it's 11 by 5.5. So, So a half a cardstock, a half a sheet is 4.25. So it's quite a bit more. So you'll have this piece left over, okay? So obviously you can make a lot with that. All right. Then you want to score this at 3 3/8. And then 3 3/8 from the other side. That's just the easiest way to do that. Unless you're really good at eighths, you can score it at 3 3/8 and 7 5/8. This way I don't have to put out this arm, okay? And then I want to cut from the score line to the edge 1 inch. So this is how I'm going to do it. I'm going to do 1 inch. So this is what's good about this paper trimmer. It has this extra side that you can line things up on. So you want the corner at the 1 inch and the score mark in the track or the groove of the cutter. So you want to keep pivoting it until it's lined up. And accuracy is key on this card, so don't let that scare you though. So then you just cut it, and then you have that little triangle, and I'll add it to my pile. And then I'm going to do the same with this end. Again, put the corner on the 1 inch, and the score mark in the middle of the track, or groove, where the blade goes. Okay, so we got something like that. Now we want to do the same with the other end. the score mark in the groove on the corner up here on the 1-inch mark. Okay. And then again down here, the corner on the 1-inch and the score mark in the groove or the track where the blade goes. And then we've got that, okay? So now we have our fun hole there. Now you want, oh, by the way, this is Pear Pizzazz that I'm using. And I can't remember the last time I used Pear Pizzazz, but I'm using it tonight because it looks really good with this. Okay, so now I want, now I want two pieces of DSP, 3 1/8 by 5 1/8. So, 3 1/8 by 5 1/8. So this is directional paper, so it's got to be facing the right way. So I want, I think I want it this way. 3 1/8. We'll try it. By 5 1/8. And 5 1/8. Yay, I think I caught it right. Woo-hoo. So it's going to go on there. Yes. Yay. I did cut a couple of those other ones that I did the other night wrong. And it's like, oh, that's not going to work. Okay. So now you want to cut these at, oh, I forgot. Oh, I know. So it's from corner to corner on the short side. So 1 inch, this corner on the 1 inch, and this corner in the groove. Okay. And then this one is corner in the groove, corner on the 1 inch mark. Again, keep pivoting it till you get it right. And then it's going to look something like that. Whew. I'm so stressed about cutting these the wrong way. Now this one will have to... Okay. Corner on the 1 inch. Corner in the groove. Hello, Robin. I'm sorry I haven't even been paying attention to comments. I'm so scared I'm going to cut this wrong. So again, one corner on the 1 inch and corner in the groove of the track. Oh! And you see? I did cut that wrong. That's going to be upside down. So I need to cut another piece. it's a challenge, but it's okay. It's going to be okay. 3 1/8 by 5 1/8. Okay. Now. So, if I want it that way, okay, corner and corner, you get that, you've got it down now, corner on the 1 inch, corner on the, and I'm probably putting it the same way. Thank you. Well, by golly, I did do it the wrong way. So let's try it. Let's try it this way. And I still have two upside down. Why am I doing that? All right, one more time. Maybe I should flip the paper over. Okay. So if I want that long, I want to cut down that. So I'm going to cut. So let me try this again. The way you can avoid this is don't use directional paper. Right? Or you could just be better at it than I am. Oh, I think I'm going to get a little bit way over there. Okay. Now I think I have two pieces that work. There we go. Yeah. Okay. So this paper, by the way, in case you did not get it, it was a celebration item. It's called Wonderful World. And it came with a stamp set, and it was free with a $100 purchase. So hopefully you got that and you can use that. It's beautiful paper. Okay. I'm going to, this is a piece of cardstock 4 inches by 5 1/4, which is going to be the insert. For the inside of the card. So you just line it up the best you can, top to bottom, left to right. And then we're going to this on, this on here, I'm actually going to go this inside first, and then I'm going to do this side. Of it DSP. I don't know that I like that for a belly band. We can try it. So I'm going to do a 1-inch strip. So again, I'm going to go over to my 1-inch on my left. So most of my paper is up against the paper trimmer for more support. So then for a belly band, you just set it on there, wrap it around, bring it around, and then I take my snips and I cut the end off, and then I put some adhesive on here. I'm looking to see if I have a sentiment real handy that I can use. I was trying to put my okay, I got one. Okay. So it's out of the cheerful basket, and I'm going to use this one. You fill my day with happiness. Oh, I love it. I love it. Whew, it's getting warm in my craft room all of a sudden. I wonder if it's the weather or if it's me. You know, me. Alright, I think I'm going to use... You know, it says Flirty Flamingo goes with this paper, but I don't care for it really. I don't have hair pizzazz. Maybe I'll just use Old Owl. I'll use Old Owl. Okay. So, but first, I want to punch out. This is the bow punch. I'm going to use that green. And then I'm going to use out of the Glimmer 12 by 12 paper. Have you guys seen this yet? Oh my gosh, it is so gorgeous. So I'm going to take it out of the cell phone so you can see it, hopefully better. But it's a must. Everybody has to have this. I don't say that a lot, but I'm telling you, your cards will just look at this. So there's Very Vanilla, Evening Evergreen, and Gold. Can you see? If you can see the shimmer or not. Oh my gosh, you guys, it is just stunning. Stunning, stunning, stunning. So I'm going to use the Very Vanilla. Actually, it's like opalescent. And I'm going to punch just the little one out of this. So, Nancy, she's on tonight. My friend Nancy that works in the studio with me. And you really can't even call it work because we have so much fun and we love what we do. But she was not in the office today, or in the studio, but I was. And Rhonda needed some things die cutting, which is usually what Nancy does. So I got to sit in Nancy's chair and use her machine and, oh my gosh, all the things. And I felt so privileged. It was so fun. Adding to my list right now. Right, Missy? It is crazy. That paper is just beautiful. Okay, so now I want a little thread. Let's see. I think I'm going to go with a white thread. White baker's twine. So anyway, I had to cut labels, stamp labels. Actually, I'm going to do a double bow. You guys like double bows? Nancy, how funny. I tell you, it was so cool. And then Nancy, I got to show you, has this tool like I do. Actually, I have it because of Nancy. So it has this long thing, and it's a magnet on the end. So when you drop your dies and you can't bend over to pick it up, you just put it on the ground and go whoop, and it picks it up. It's so, so cool. Anyways, I had to use that today, Nancy. So I hope I put it back in the right place. But oh boy, that's stressful when you drop that. Okay, so I'm just doubling my twine here. I'm making a loop. I'm making a bow. Who likes to make bows? I know I ask this a lot, but I actually do like to make things. And then we found out yesterday in the studio that Nancy likes to fussy cut. Well, I don't know if she likes it, but she's good at it. So guess what her new job is for Rhonda? We have so much fun. Okay, I'm putting that back. All right. Now, I want this to go here. That's going to go on there. So I have that much room. Oh, it might help if I have it right side up. I could do that. Oh, yeah, I could do that and then have it off to the side. Okay, so I'm going to stamp it high so it fits on there and it doesn't get covered up with the bow punch. Okay. Is that too loud? Sorry. So tap, tap, tap. Press down, straight down, and straight up. Yay. And then I'm going to take some simple shamming. Clean my stamp right now. It's all clean. Put it back. I'm looking for my stamp set. It's right next to me. Crazy, crazy. Okay. But then, all right. Then I want. So now I need my mini glue dots. I owe a friend a card flex. Tell me about your Monday night classes. Ooh. So my Monday night classes, thank you for asking, Missy. It's the fourth Monday of the month. So it's not always the last Monday, but it is the fourth Monday of the month. From 6:30 to 8, we meet up at Rhonda's studio. Rhonda lets me use her studio for my class. She's so generous. I just love her. She's just so, so kind. And we make 8 cards, 2 each of 4 different designs. And they come with the envelopes. And the class is $20 for free with a minimum $25 purchase. So it's quite a deal if you make a purchase because then you get all those cards for free. So we would make like 2 of these cards, 2 of another card, 2 of another card, 2 of another card. Sometimes I make like a 3D project. So we did this one time. So your combo glue sits in it. One time, just recently, I don't know where it went to. I don't see it, but we made the box that held the 5 cards inside it. So that was a class too. So yeah, it's different every month and very affordable and very fun. And yeah, that's my card class. Okay, where am I going with this? This needs something. Oh, I bet. I know. It's going to need some gems, some embellishments. Okay. So I have this these dimensionals, and they're coming off the paper. I mean, they're not, like, it's not lifting off, so there's no sticky end of that. So I got tired of messing with it, but I thought, oh, maybe some of them will work. Well, these are working, so I use every bit of the dimensionals that are on that sheet, because I don't use just the 100 that are on here. I use everything around it to the frame. It all works, and you can't see it, so it doesn't matter what it looks like on the back, right? What time again? My internet says it's unstable sometimes. Ooh. My class is 6:30 to 8. And if we... Oh, I didn't want to put them there. I wanted to put them on the... Put them on the belly band. So then you won't stick it to the card and your belly band will slide like it's supposed to. So yep, 6:30 to 8. Sometimes we run a little over. I do not rush you. So if we go to 8:30, that's fine. It doesn't bother me. Oh my gosh, you guys, I'm loving this card. I'm just winging it. Because this is not the style, this is not the pattern that I'm using for my swap, but oh, it's just cute. Okay, we need some dots. Dots. And I want shiny. Pretty. These are the 2021-23 in color opal rounds. Won't those look beyond there? Oh my gosh. So I've misplaced my take your pick tool. I have no idea where it is. So I have this little pointy thing that will work. So I just... I'll do a purple one. Oh, it wants to stick to my finger. And should I do yellow or green? This light green color, which is soft succulent, which is one of my favorites. Ah! Put it right there. Oh, look at that. Do you like? Let me know. Thumbs up. Like. Yes. No. Not for you. Gotta have it all. Okay. So now I'm going to show you a Christmas card. So this Christmas card may be in one of my 12 weeks of Christmas, which starts September 13th. So stay tuned for that. I'm going to set this aside. Okay. So for this card, I need an 8.5 by 5.5. Scored at 4.25, so it's your common card base, and it's very vanilla. Okay, then I have a piece of 4 by 5.25. Oh, what was that? Embossing folder's name. I have it right at the tip. It is the Wintry 3D, and it's actually the evergreen embossing folder, not the snowflakes, but the evergreen. So I just did it on the one edge of the paper. That's all I wanted it on. Okay. Then I'm going to take a piece of ribbon, which is Evening Evergreen, and I'm going to, this is really simple, I'm not tying a bow, yeah, shocker, thank you, Jenny, and all I'm doing is wrapping it around right where the edges of that embossing folder. I'm using my Seal Plus. Gluing that down like so. Pretty easy so far, right? Okay. Then, I guess we can put it on there right now. We're going to pop that up with dimensionals. I'm going to use that. Oh, that's it for that sheet. So, Jenny, do you make cards? We got to get you over to Sue's and make some cards together. Okay, I'm going to put this, center it, left to right, up and down, okay? Then I'm going to take a piece of very vanilla, it's 2 inches by 3 inches, and I'm going to take my new die. Oh my gosh, it's so beautiful, it's a Christmas tree. And this is Tree Trimmings Die. It actually is available as a bundle September 1st, starting today, through September 30th, and it pairs with Trimming the Tree stamp set. So beautiful. Okay, so it comes with all these other dies. So there's bows and stars, more bows, labels, ornaments. Oh, those are little ornaments. How fun. Oh, this is a pumpkin and an acorn and a pumpkin, I think. Is it? Maybe? No, those are ornaments. Those are ornaments. I'm wondering if they can be used as pumpkins. Just thinking. Has a pot or, you know, for a tree stand, and then a scallop, like for lights or garland. Oh, so many possibilities. Okay, so I'm going to take my mini stamp and emboss machine. Actually, it's called stamp and cut and emboss machine. Move this out of the way. I got my plates. This mini sits right on my workstation, so it's very easy access. And I can just grab it and use it and then put it right back. Okay, so I'm putting that die in there, that Christmas tree, and I'm going to roll it through. It's easy peasy. And then you get something like that, and you think, oh, Arlena, what is that? Ew, it's not very pretty. Oh, but you wait. Oh, but wait, there's more. If you act now. Oh, my husband and I always do that. You act now, you can double your whatever. Okay, so I'm going to take, I wish I knew where my take my pick tool was. So I'm going to turn this over, and I'm actually going to push in. These do not poke out. They just, they just fold out. So they're going to stay, they're going to stay attached to the piece of card stuff. So this takes a little bit of time, not much at all, but it's so worth it when you're done. Trust me, have I ever led you astray? Ever? Ever. If I did, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. But I don't think I have. I'm pretty honest, I'm a pretty open book. I like something or love something, I let you know. Like that glimmer paper, you gotta have it. It is so beautiful, you guys. So beautiful. And we're gonna... Okay, so you see, this is looking like... So we're gonna rough all that up. Just keep poking it out. Not poking it out, poking it up. So it looks like such. Okay? Right? Okay. Now for the wow factor. Don't turn away. If you've got to go to the bathroom, do not go to the bathroom. So remember the glimmer paper came with the very vanilla and the gold and the evergreen. We are going to use a piece of the evergreen, and we are going to glue this down with our stamp and seal plus. And I'm going to make sure those are up before I glue this down to the bottom. Alright, I'm going to put a piece of down here too. Okay. And then you want to center this top to bottom, left to right. Oh, you guys! Oh my gosh, I'm just fluffing up those branches a little bit. And then I'm going to put some seal plus on the back of that. Again, pop that up. Oh, you guys, this is so beautiful. And I know it's not as beautiful on camera. I just know it. And then that goes over that. And there's your card. And you can put the sentiment inside Merry Christmas or... See, I don't do season's greetings. I do Merry Christmas or something sentimental. Actually, let's see what we have in the set. Sending Christmas cheer. May your season be merry and bright. Happy holidays. Oh, I don't do happy holidays. Peace and joy. Those aren't floating my fancy. Oh, I see another one. Hang on. My knee is giving me fits tonight. And it's hard to maneuver. Okay. So Brightest Glow has all these sentiments. Always merry and bright. Wishing you a season of hope and light to you and yours this Christmas. May the peace of the season light your world and may your new year be the brightest. Oh, that's pretty. Hoping your Christmas shines bright with the love of family and friends. Ooh, I like that too. I don't know which one I want. Or we could just do Merry Christmas. That's pretty. Okay. I'm going to do... Oh, see? It's brand new. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to assemble a stamp. We're going to do... May the peace of the season light your world and may your new year be the brightest. Oh, do I want that? Or do I want hoping your Christmas shines bright with the love of family and friends? I love family and friends. I'm going to do family and friends. Okay. So now I gotta find the stamp. So it's hope. So you just pull it out of the rubber frame, if you will. You peel this wax coat backing off of it. You can discard that. This is not sticky, so it's just shiny. I'm gonna make sure I have a camera here. Then you take the sticker, and on the back it's slit in half. All of them are slit in half, so you peel those off. And then it's backwards, so it's kind of tricky, but you'll see that the stamp is the same as the sticker. So then you line it up. You don't ever want to touch that sticker. It's really sticky, and once you touch it, it doesn't stick anymore. So you want to make sure you get this lined up right the first time. So I just line it up in that outline, press down, lift up, and there you go. See? Thanks for designing my this year's Christmas card. Isn't it so simple, so gorgeous, and not a lot of supplies or product? So you have very vanilla, you have the glimmer paper, and depending on how many cards you send, this is only 2.25 by 3.25, so you can get quite a bit out of a 12 by 12 sheet. And you get 2 sheets in each pack. Or you could do another color. So let me get this on there, and then I want to show you something. So this is Evening Evergreen. So obviously, I want to stamp this in Evening Evergreen ink. So, okay, it doesn't want to open. It really doesn't want to open. There we go. And then tap, 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 tap. Make sure it's all... Okay, so you see how it's all gunky there? I don't like that, because that's what's going to come off on the paper. So I just had... I just remembered something that a demonstrator that I follow, she's... I guess she's a friend. She doesn't know me. I've never met her in person. But I love her stamping. I love her personality. She's a friend of Rhonda's. And, oh my goodness, I don't have it. There's a sanding block. Okay, I don't know where it went to. So I'm going to use a file, an emery board. Just rub it over lightly. That's it. And that left some residue, so I'm going to... a little bit. Apparently, when Stampin' Up! Makes these stamps, there is a film over the red rubber of stamps, and it can affect the way it stamps the first time. So, we're just gonna try this again. Oh, we don't want it upside down. That wouldn't be good, would it? Straight down, and line this up. And straight up. Oh, this Evening Evergreen. I love dark green. I love green. Go MSU. I hope we have a good football season this year. So there we have our card. Beautiful, huh? Now, I want to show you what I did right before we went live. And here it is in gold. So see? Aren't they stunning? So this ribbon, this gold ribbon, is actually gold. Gold. That's what it says. Satin edged ribbon, gold. And then this one is the Evening Evergreen ribbon, which is the in color. So what do you like? Do you like gold or do you like the green? Oh, too hard to choose. I tell you, too hard to choose. Alright, putting that stamp away. Putting my block away. And bringing my other card here. So did you like what we did tonight? Oh, I feel like there's just a mess around here. So what do you think? Both. You like both of them, Sue. Yeah, they are. They're stunning. The one that I actually saw that I cased was the gold. And then I thought, oh my gosh, it's going to look beautiful with that green glimmer paper. And it did not disappoint. It is just as beautiful. Just as beautiful. Okay, I am going to bring you down and point you up to my face. So look away if you get motion sickness, because I don't want you to get sick. Thank you, Nancy. Thank you. So I hope you will make these cards if you have the supplies. If not, make something close to it. Always, you know, post a picture. I'd love to see what you're doing. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up or some hearts. That would be great. Be sure to share it with your friends and family. That would be appreciated as well. So September 1st today kicks off the Dive Partners. That's not what it's called. So is anyone else hearing a buzzing sound? Ooh, that's not good. I wonder what it is. I don't have my ear pods in. I don't know what it is. So, yes. Oh, you do too? Oh, that's not good. I've got to figure it out. Let me try to... Does that help? I just unplugged my charging cord. I don't know if that helped or not. So today is September 1st, and Stampin' Up! Has released some bundle partners. I don't know what they're called. I'm totally lost. Anyway, where you can get the dies that match certain bundles. They've created dies for these stamp sets that did not have dies before. So you can only get them through September 30th for the bundle, and you'd save 10% with that. So this one that I use is the tree trimming dies and the set. Yes, trimming the tree. Perfect Partners die set. Thank you, Nancy. I knew you'd come through for me. You can't ever go away. I need you. We all need you because you keep us on track. Hello, Mary. I'm glad you joined us. Go back and watch the replay. We've got some gorgeous cards we made tonight. And I showed you how to do them. There it is in gold. And then we did a fun fold. So make sure you go back and watch that. Another thing that Stampin' Up! Released today was weekly deals. So be sure to check out stampinup.com and check out those deals. There's, I don't know, maybe 10 or 12 different things that are on sale. So be sure to get those products while you can at a discount. Really cute stuff. The brass butterflies that are adhesive on the back are on sale. So that would be wonderful to use. Wonderful to use on a card like, here's the box. Missy, this is one of my card classes that we did. So we made the box, and it closes with a magnet, and then inside are five different cards. So this one would look cute with those brass butterflies on it. Yeah. Hello, Bonnie. Good to see you. All right. So those are the Stampin' Up! Specials. And then September 13th is when I have my first week of of Christmas. I'm doing 12 weeks of Christmas. Every Tuesday I'll come to you for 12 weeks with a kit that you can purchase, and it will be shipped directly to your house. Also, next week I will be camping again, my last hurrah for the year, for the season. And unfortunately, there is no McDonald's around where we're going, so I can't get the Wi-Fi. So we will not be going live next Thursday night. So if I can, I'm going to get something around and come to you on Monday night. But I'll keep you posted on that. Tuesday night, I have my Rubber Queen meeting with Rhonda. So I'm busy that night, so I couldn't do it that night. But yeah, so hang in there and keep stamping and share the love. And we will talk to you later. Have a good evening. Go green. Bye-bye.